If you like this video, press the like button and subscribe this channel and press the bell icon to get notification of our new videos.
Hello everyone, welcome to mpcs.com. So this is our 8th lecture on dermatology series, and we will cover all the topics of dermatology, all the important topics within a month. So please subscribe the channel, press the bell icon, and also watch the previous series, previous lectures. The link is given in the description below, and also I request you to download the notes of this topic also. The link is given in the description. So let's begin with this. So the topic of this lecture is hyperpigmentary disorders. Okay, so as the name suggests, hyperpigmented. Okay, so the main disorder which will be covered in hyperpigmentary disorder is melasma. Okay, this is very important for your NEET PG exam as well as your Viva exam. So what is the etiology of melasma? Okay, it can be hormonal or it can be sun exposed. Okay, so what happens in the hormonal at the time of pregnancy, after taking OCP and HRT, the estrogen causes the melasma, okay, or hyperpigmentary disorder. Okay, and it is also associated with hypothyroidism. The another cause is sun exposure. Okay, the sun exposure, the main light or main rays involved are UVB rays. Okay, UVB exposure, excessive UVB exposure causes the melasma. Now coming to the clinical features, the main clinical feature is brownish discoloration of skin, mainly of the skin of the face. Okay, and it can be of three types on the basis of its site. It can be of three types. The first type is centrofacial. The second type is mandibular, and the third type is maxillary. Okay, so the centrofacial part, this type is the most common type. Now what happens here, I draw this face, look at this. If this area is involved, the nose area or central area is involved, then it is known as centrofacial. Okay, so how do we write it as central part of the face is involved. Okay, now what happens in the mandibular type, this area is involved, then it is a mandibular type. Okay, so outer, this is outer. Okay, and lower area of the face. Okay, now if this area and this area is involved, then it is outer upper area of face is involved in maxillary type. Okay, so this is the, these are the types of melasma. Now coming to the treatment part. So as we know that this is a hyperpigmented disorder, so we have to give the depigmenting agent. What is the depigmenting agent here? We have tyrosinase inhibitors. And what are these tyrosinase inhibitors? We can give topical. The topical agent is hydroquinone. Okay, and the another one is azelaic acid. Okay, now another part of treatment is sun protection. The sun protection is also an important part here, because UVB exposure can also cause melasma. So the sun exposure, we can prevent it either from physically or either chemically. Okay, physically we can prevent it as by covering our face, cover the face. And chemically we can prevent it as after apply sunscreen. Okay, now the another part and the main part here for the treatment is there is a formula, Kligman's formula. We can apply it on the lesion. So what it contains? It contains three things. What are these things? Hydroquinone plus tretinoin plus steroids. So these three things forms a Kligman formula. Okay, now coming to the image part. So as you can see in this image, this is an image of melasma. Okay, you can see central hyperpigmented lesions here. You can also see this lesion. These are maxillary lesion. You can also see the mandibular lesions here. Okay, these are also involved. Okay, so this is hyperpigmented lesions present on the face. Okay, now I would like to show you another image. Look at this. What is this? Can you identify this? I can give you 10 seconds. You can identify this. Is this a melasma? No, this is not a melasma. So what is this? These are not hyperpigmented patches. These are red in color. Okay, and you can see this shape here. This is the butterfly shape. Okay, you can also see here that this area is not involved. Nasolabial folds are not involved in this type of lesion. Okay, these are red. The nasolabial folds are not involved. This is of butterfly shape. So this is SLE rash. Okay, so this is the difference between SLE rash and the melasma. So this is all for this video. Hope you like this video. Please press the like button and also share this video with your friends, and please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for more videos. In the next video, we will discuss about hypopigmented patches, the disease is vitiligo. So thank you for watching. Keep subscribing. Thank you.